Hello.
Wow, I think even know that exists in my LinkedIn profile, honestly. Okay, I think that probably is a bit bombastic, huh? I'm just a normal person. I just want to do the stuff I like. And basically, I like retail. I like online, and I'm a computer science student. So you combine technology and you combine internet, basically, and retail, right? What do you get? You get e-commerce. That's what I'm doing, huh? That's the love of my life, right? So today, basically, I want to mainly cover the topic of marketplaces. May I have a show of hand, how many of you are already selling at marketplaces? One only. Two. So most of you have not started selling at any marketplaces yet. Elong, Lazada, 11th Street. Huh? So today my overview might be useful for you, right? Give you some useful information for you to kickstart, huh? If we're looking at starting in marketplaces. So a bit intro about me, myself first. I'm actually from Bukit Panjang. My house not too far from Anwar Ibrahim home only. Basically I graduated in 1997 as a GSIM boy. Then I entered UTM. Basically the course, my first to fifth choice, I take computer science. If I cannot get it, I'll go from sixth. Okay? So, but luckily, we got in, we graduated, and before my work, I will join CNET. You know CNET.com? Everyone heard of? Before the time of Engadget, all these sites, right? CNET was a top technology site. They're actually having a CNET Malaysia in the Ambar Plaza there. So I was their first intern, and I was also their last intern. Because after the end of my internship, right, they fold it. Because they ship all the operation back to Singapore. Okay? I think they cannot sell any ad. It's not sustainable. Huh? Just like recently, another media site, TMI, the Malaysian Insider, just folded. After they report that, they lose about 10 million ringgit. Yes, it's crazy. You need to feed about 59 staff. Huh? Good journalism does cost money. Then, after I graduate, I bump into a work that I cannot refuse to not to take. Mainly, this is a special project by this company called OYL Manufacturing. Anyone know OYL Manufacturing? The company sells aircon, York Accent. If you heard of these two brands. So OYL Manufacturing was one of the Malaysian most successful manufacturers ever. And it was also the first company from Malaysia go and buy a US company one called McQuaid Air Conditioners. Okay? Of course, it's part of the Hong Kong Group back then. Then the founder actually got a special project. The idea is very simple. I want to sell aircon online. Later I'll show you this. This unit. Anyone seen it? This is the aircon, right? We try to sell online. Below 700 ringgit. Okay? No installer required. Means you have to rebuild a bracket. Then the idea is people can just buy online, swap this thing to the bracket, then plug and play, right? Just switch it on. Then it's jalan. Of course, the whole project eventually didn't take off. But the unit I'm showing you here, right, I actually involved in the manufacturing process of this unit until the build out of the website, until selling it, until trying to pitch a developer. So the whole project, I think, burned the company a couple of millions. Yeah, in 3 years' time, failed. But that's, you know, OPM, other people money, so it doesn't kill us yet. So that's how I got started into the world of e-commerce. Then, as you know, today, e-commerce Milo, do subscribe to our newsletter. We are the site that talk about, mainly we have a lot of statistics, right? If you want to know more about the market condition, check us out. And you want to know more insights about e-commerce and how to actually get started selling online, how to do better marketing, subscribe to our newsletter on this one. And I also founded a group called Mecca. If you are you get your mobile, you search for MECA, try to join this group. It's an active community, right? I founded on Facebook. That we have merchants, we have payment gateway providers, we have platform providers like me, we have media, we have shipping logistic providers. Even Nabil, the next great speaker, I'm going to share with you inside. So you can discuss almost about anything here. So let's not further ado. I start with my topic today. I want basically kickstart with you basically a milestone of Malaysia e-commerce. The first thing, right, that got us kickstart is actually AirAsia. Back in the year 2001. This is the first time I think a lot of Malaysians actually experienced buying online. Because if you want cheap ticket, it's the only way to purchase. So it forces you, right, to change your behavior. Okay, even though you're scared it might not secure, but it's cheap. Right, Malaysian like cheap stuff. So it forces you to actually buy online. Then the second phase comes 10 years later. We call it deal site clones. At the peak of this phase, right, there are almost more than 100 group selling sites in Malaysia alone. And today, can you tell me who is that? Group buying site? Anyone still purchase from group buying site? Remember the day of Living Social? Groupon? Of course, Groupon is the only, I think, sole survivors that is still actively running now. Okay, that's how fast the tide turns. Why we call it the wave 2? Because before this wave, right, if you approach merchant, even traditional merchant that are very successful, have brand, right, they will never believe consumers will buy their products online. They don't believe. After this, they see firsthand, right, there are tons of people buying things online. Of course, you start with a voucher thing. And now today, we are going to touch on this one. Later, I show you, share with you some of the marketplace, some of their details. And we call it the marketplace battle, which we are still in now. Probably it will last for another 3 to 5 years before we'll see who is the ultimate winner. Okay, and you can see the marketplace battle 3 here, they are no longer SME play. Meaning all these players, you know Lazada, 11th Street, they come in with what? Big money. Big money. Just to give you a glimpse of the big money, like Lazada 2014, 2015, right? How much sales they are generating? Can anyone tell me? 214, 215. Huh? USD or ringgit? USD. Okay, less than that actually. Less than that. But it's the whole region, not just Lazada, Malaysia. So, the whole region, Lazada, Vietnam, Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, all combined, right? 214, 215, they do about 150 million plus USD. Do they make money? No, right? Then, how much money they lose then? Huh? Any idea? Yeah, of course they lose money. If they don't make money, they sure lose money, right? You cannot be exactly break even. They lose about 150 plus million as well, USD. So the whole cost, you look at it, right, to run the whole operation is about 300 plus USD million in a year alone. You find 4 point something, it's 1 point something billion in a year. This is the kind of big money we are talking about. Of course, they don't spread out into the country. Right. Then you look at 11th Street. I think last year alone, they spent about 60 to 70 million on the operating cost plus marketing, everything alone. So it's not something you can start with. If it's just a few million in the bank, right, it won't be enough. That becomes this kind of skill. And then, okay, these are some of the new marketplace, right, apart covering the timeline. Log on later, I will share more details. Okay, this is my Sinju Media Group one, which is, I think, one of the sponsors in CTEC also. Then you have Go Shop. Anyone shop in Go Shop before? Go Shop. Why you shop there?
For my mom.
Exactly. So Go Shop is doing very well now. TV shopping is not something exactly new in Malaysia. Okay, but previously, Malaysia company, how do they do TV shopping? What do they do? Masali program. Copy and paste. Right? Then they just air it. So we don't feel like it's connected to us, the content, the language, right? Even the people. It doesn't connect to us. We don't think that, you know, we don't look like them at all. Right? So this one, they bring in GS Home Shopping, one of the leading TV shopping provider, I think, in Korea. They work with them, they localize the content. So they get local content, local languages, local stuff. So you add all these things. And why I can tell you they are doing very good now. My friends told me his mom insists him, right, purchase a frying pan from Go Shop because that's the only way to buy original. So this is from, again, the mom side. If you win over the mom, I mean you win everything. Okay? Then you have 11th Street. Just now we talked about actually a JV between Cellcom and SK Telecom. Okay? These are two gigantic companies as well. But those who really run and execute it, share it, right, are actually the talent from the SK Planet app. Because SK Planet, they operate 11th Street in Korea, which are, I think, currently still the number one marketplace player in Korea. Then you have Gen 5. Okay, this is by Hong Leong Bank, okay, part of Hong Leong Group. And new marketplaces, anyone know? By Aeon?
Kapoor.
Good. I conducted a lot of class there, a lot of people don't know about it. convinced that you guys are pretty up to date and educated on this end. Any new marketplaces?
Shopee.
Yes, mobile one. That's one of the category. Other than that? Lenovo is definitely that one. I think it's probably the only Malaysian survivors. And they are probably the only profitable one. Where? Aladdin? Aladdin, you heard, huh? By our space astronaut one. Let's see what they come up with. Don't be surprised, there will be more new emerging players. And there are other players like, you heard of Jilza. Right, so they position themselves as the hard-on marketplaces. So you see, different kind of verticals, right, will pop up. And if you have not get started selling online yet, normally this is a job we share on e-commerce Milo. We tell people X axis, you have high product know-how, meaning you know how to source, you know what you want to sell maybe. And you know exactly how to drive traffic, who to target. You should sell your own branded store. You can look at a good example like Malaysian one, right? A lot of Muslimah fashion store. Most of them run own branded store one. They probably start with social media, Facebook, Instagram, then extend to the own branded store for further automation. Otherwise you keep PM, right? You'll lose some orders, very hard to handle, cannot scale. But if you have high product knowledge, but you don't know how to drive traffic, you have very little knowledge about digital marketing, and you don't trust a digital agency, what do? Consider to open a shop in marketplaces first. Okay, if you are doing fashion, you can consider fashion verticals like Zalora, right? Or Fashion Valley, Fashion Valley. Or if you are doing, let's say, electronic items, you can try out Lenovo. Because majority of their customers are, I think 55 to 60% are male. So things like that. And what if you have, high marketing know-how, but you don't know what to sell? You probably want to open a marketplace and find a niche. You study the list of items. Right, that you probably can find a niche that you know that people want, but nobody is offering it yet. You could start there. Right, because nowadays, right, there's no other cheaper ways to actually kickstart a business than selling online in marketplace. Because almost a lot of them are offered for free. Okay? And just now someone mentioned about Shopee, right? They even absorb your the paper giveaway fee. That's crazy. You sell 100 ringgit, take back 100 ringgit. And if you don't know these two, you have to attend more classes offered by CTEC first. Learn more first, then later, sooner later, you'll find some ideas, right? Then you can start. Okay. So, Lelong, anyone selling Lelong now? How's it doing for you? What product are you selling?
T-shirt.
Is it for male or female?
Pregnant lady.
Oh, this is something special category. Because for Lelong, right, of course, they are the, I would say, right, the out of all the big marketplaces now, they are the probably the only Malaysian made now, have a lot of traffic one. They claim they have 8 million monthly visitors, like 2 million resident members. They have classes, okay, and they accept individual and company. So when you come to marketplaces, before you join, most of them, they want a registered company. But Lenovo started as a C2C, which is a consumer-to-consumer platform one. They will take individual. Means today you don't have to register with SSM, you can actually start selling them as well. And this product category and merchant-centric, right, basically applies to most of marketplaces. So product category means what? When you go to a marketplace, consumers, as a consumer to buy something, you will notice, right, they promote product and product category. Or brands of the product only. They seldom talk about merchant one. Or sometimes you buy something, you don't care who is it from, because you know that you are dealing with that particular website only. So a good example of this is Lazada. Okay? When you buy from Lazada, when most of the customers buy from Lazada, right, they don't care who is selling it, because if they don't like the item, they know they can return. And they send back to Lazada, Lazada is going to refund to them. So this is a product category driven type. And why this is important? Because product category driven type of marketplace, right, is a good place for you to sell, and sell only. It's never a place for you to build your own brand. Okay? So it's a sales channel. You have to look at it this way. It's never a place for you to build brand. As for merchant-centric one, a classic example will be Rakuten, who unfortunately recently have decided to actually fold off the operation here in South Asia, and they actually closed down, I think due to a stiff competition. But they are a good example of merchant-centric. Means they promote merchant. They let you have full control. Okay, you can even plot your banner, how you want to decorate the header, how you want to run the voucher. They let you decide. They even let you right, blast out newsletters right, using their own engine to their customer that subscribe to the newsletter. So these are merchant-centric. Okay, and they let you control your own refund return process and everything else. Very merchant-centric. Okay? Some are a bit of both. Okay? Then if you want to sell a landlord, go for this. They have basically Lelong web standard web store and also the web store plus. It will cost you the store fee about 500 ringgit a year. Okay, why this? Because they have all the plug-in, right? Even like PayPal that you can utilize with this plan. It's only 500. And you can even utilize the API. API will let you right talk to program. You know, I also run another company called WebShaper. It let you talk to other platforms that can let you push and synchronize the product details, pricing, and stock. Oh, that's a general idea. And you look at the fee here, most of the marketplace earn money while charging you commission. Okay, remember. Then Lelong commission is based on category. In fact, most of the marketplaces is based on their master category on the commission. So it depends on when you upload a new product, right? This product you upload to which category, so they will charge you commission if there is a successful transaction. Okay. And the commission 0.3 to 8%, and plus the payment fee is what you are utilizing something they call a net pay. So your total cost of selling there will be 500, 2.5 or 3.5% depends on how your customer pay, plus the commission right, of where your product resides in the category. Okay. So that's for that. So this is one example of a client selling at that. Then Lazada. How many of you have not purchased from Lazada yet? Don't plan to try. Why? Don't trust them.
No size.
Huh?
No size.
Sorry?
No size.
Oh. Richard, how about electronic stuff? So, okay, Lazada, I think, without a doubt, is currently the leading players right, in terms of Malaysian marketplace. All of my customers who sell in Lazada, they complain about a lot of things. They never complain about they don't have sales. Okay, so that's how much right traffic and sales they could drive you if you just supply the right product. Lazada, the latest update is right, they have about more than 5 million SKU. I'm talking about Lazada Malaysia. So about 30% of their total delivery are done via COD. Okay? And they currently have about 10,500 sellers on their site, which include local sellers and also overseas sellers. That overseas sellers, you see some of the products, right, they take longer time to deliver. That's how they get to the 5 million SKU point. Because they are not going to, if you're selling something online, your competition is no longer just local merchant. Take note of that. And you have to give Lazada credit for pioneering the COD thing here. Of course, the first company that really offering COD here is, I think, Yamato. Then when Lazada come in, right, they actually use their volume and sizes, right, to actually open up and I think force or even negotiate, right, the company like GDEC to start offering COD for them. They only take registered company, SSM only. Okay, individual, sorry, don't take. If you want to sell something there, you gotta register a company with SSM. And they are the classic example of product category centric type. Sell. And they are the only, I think, the marketplace here, they actually they have a sourcing team that buy products and sell their own product. They also have some brand category only they can sell, you cannot sell. Okay, so there's like a frenemy kind of relationship there, you want to sell that. So if you attend Lazada seller conference, right, every year there will be people complain, say, hey, you know, I sell this product, suddenly I don't have sales. Then I found out Lazada, I go and source it. Sell the same product as me and then offer lower price. You have to understand this could happen in Lazada. Okay, because this is how it works. So this is the rule of game, you want to participate in the game. And this is their plan, quite simplistic, have a payment fee, 2% flat. And commission again based on category, anything from 1 to 12%. One thing about them is, right, you have to know also, they are very good at doing one thing. After you get the order, if you don't ship out in 48 hours, they'll penalize you. Okay, how they penalize you is a percentage of your total order value up to a maximum of 50 ringgit. So imagine, right, you are selling, let's say, a product at your own website, and then you are also selling the same product at Lazada, and you only have one stock only. You get this product, you get two orders today. You will give it to customer in Lazada first. Okay? You give it to customer in Lazada first. So that's why, right, the emphasis of customer experience tells me if they continue to do that, they might be one of the main players, right, that will last until has the last laugh. Okay? Because they emphasize on this. Then if you sell other marketplace also, you always give Lazada first. Then the customer with better experience, they'll buy more, they trust it more. So it's a good cycle for them. And then they also have this, when you sell Lazada, you have to take note. This one, the buyer protection program, let's say up to 14 days one, right, is something you have to adhere to. So meaning you sell there, you don't get to set your own return policy. You have to accept that. Then, of course, you always hear horror story, right? My example of my client, they sell a laser printer, return back, okay, money returned to buyers already, they check, no problem, then send back to my merchant, they open it up, the cartridge used up. Yes, that's Malaysian consumer. So you give an idea, you want to do event, right, quick one, you can buy a laser printer from the other time. Don't tell you that you're learning here from a CTEC class here. Okay? So it's a low-cost way to run event. You can borrow a lot of stuff from them by utilizing these 14 days, right, returns. And Rakuten, since he spoke, I'm going to do a quick one also, something you have to know. They are still number one players in Japan. Just that, their investment in South Asia, I think, is not growing as they expected. That's why they decide to fold it. They're very merchant-centric, as I mentioned. And instead of using voucher, and discount, they use point. Okay, they use point. So that you accumulate the point, then you come back for more. And this is their plan. It no longer apply, but just to give you a glimpse, they probably are on the higher side, but actually they reduce the fee already. When they are here in Malaysia, they used to starting at 6,000 minimum ringgit again, plus the commission. Yes, that was before Lazada, Marketplace, and of course 11th Street, they all come in. And of course, Lelong is there. Lelong has always been a very low-cost way to actually start up your store. 11th Street, anyone selling there currently? No. So 11th Street is one of the fastest growing marketplaces here also. I can tell you, Lazada monitor only a few people only, and this is one of it. Okay, this is one of the, I think, considered one of the top competitors, right, in Malaysia. And they really spend a lot of money, okay, multi-million marketing budget, as I mentioned. And you can see their ad, and also they use, even they buy a YouTube ad just to dish out voucher. Okay, they are very, very good at using coupon code. Okay, and then you will see that before this, 11th Street, actually they come in, they do something different. Instead of use voucher code, right, to encourage you to buy big item, what they do is, they disperse small value coupon code, maybe 10 ringgit, right, but last for only 1 day or 2 days. Then they get you to buy Milo. They get you to buy Nescafe. These are all household items. And they manage to successfully sign a lot of anti-customer. Yes. Don't forget, whoever control the trust of the mom, you control the household purchase. Remember that. That's how powerful it is. And when they come in, they do something very different. I think they are probably the first marketplace to do something called a seller zone. Where they set up photo studio, I think, this one. Okay. Then training rooms. If you are their customer, you just register an account, it's totally free. You can actually book it to use for free. And I myself, I have a customer that go and book the photo studio and shoot all his fashion product. Okay, in a single day. And then upload to the site. And again, very simple way of charging, either 5 or 10%. And out of all the marketplace, they are the one with the promptest and most automated payment. Order by order. So payment side, merchant love them. Everything automated. Then log on. Okay. Log on, right? Is by the Sinju Media Group, okay, the largest Chinese media publication in Malaysia. I think for the publication side, the largest for the Malay market will be Kan Kan. But this is for the Chinese reader side. And across all their sites, they own all these Sinju, Nanyang, China Press. They have about 50 million page views. Okay? So they actually commit, right, to use all these page views to promote this log on site if you sign up as a merchant. Then again, it's free. Okay? Free to join. You can take a look. Product listing, they don't control you. Payment gateway fee, la 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 la, running at 2%. Handling fee, I think, this one, let me find one, I'm not too sure it's for product item or not. Then their commission is either 1 or 3% on top. Okay, very low. But mainly targeting Chinese reader market now. Before they expand further, because this is their strength. And also one of the very unique thing, if you work with them, this example is by one of my friend and customer, the Gundam of mine. If you sell there, you give them a deal, they will take your product, put on the color ad on their newspaper. So normally, you know, newspaper ad never come cheap, right? Even though readers slowly going down. But this kind of exposure, right, will help you get your brand recognized. And it does help out, right, slowly but surely generating more sales for the merchant as well. You can see they are very committed. Every single day, you are reading Chinese newspaper across all these different kind of paper owned by them. You see that they have been promoting all these items. So this is something very unique offered by them. And I think their merchant love it a lot on site. Now I come to Shoppu. Shoppu will be, okay, by Aeon. Some of you, I already know that. Their strength against, of course, Aeon 1.2 million card members. A lot. Probably the most successful royalty card member in Malaysia, if you ask me. Don't forget, these 1.2 million card members are paid one, not free one. That makes a lot of difference. Okay? And they target middle and high income group. Again, cost you nothing to join. Okay, you are a merchant, this is one of the actually platform you want to look into. They're definitely in for a long-term trade. And commission anything from 3 to 25% inclusive of payment fee. Just one thing, if you join them, you have to utilize the courier services, right, assigned by them. Okay, not like 11 Street or whatever, you ship your products out using PostAzu, using GDEX, using Skynet, whichever you like, whichever you have account with. This one, they will give you a pre-print consignment note. Okay? You have to call, right, their designated providers, which is currently now only GDEX. Then GDEX will come and pick up the thing from you, they send. Oh, they have a charges on them. And all of them, they have classes. One. If you join them, you ask for more info. This is an onboarding process. You have to attend their classes to get to know more about their flow. Okay, then you can start selling. And last one, I'm going to talk about Shopee. Anyone sell a Shopee already? Not yet. Going to. I think this is, I actually have a shop there also. Probably the easiest to set up one because it's a mobile app marketplace. You just download this app called Shopee. Start shooting photos of unwanted stuff at your home. Start putting up a price. Then you can start selling directly. Yes. And the back end currently is powered by iPay. I think then you can actually pay on my one. Compared to other apps like Carousel, you can't yet. Okay? And they are very, very aggressive. Everything is free. Okay, this is unheard of. Because normally, even other marketplaces, they charge you a commission, right? They charge you a payment fee, right? This one is totally free for now. And they pump in, right, a multi-million budget into promoting it as well. Very aggressive. You can see here, nothing. Means the payment gateway fee, the credit card fee, they actually absorb it. They are real cost. Right? And for some merchant, you work out the deal with them, they absorb your shipping cost also. Okay? It's a bit manual now, the way you actually listing there, but it's all free. Okay, so again, it's a no-brainer for you to start up. Any question so far on marketplace? No, so no already. Okay, I want to share something about what I do. I run an e-commerce platform company that empower you to build your own web store and also sell multi-channel as well. So the thing I do on it relate to my know-how of the marketplaces. This is what happened, right, to most of my clients. When you are setting up your own branded store, right, you are isolated islands, right, filled with all the nice trees but nobody knows about. And when they cannot sell, next year they don't renew because no business. Okay? So what we're trying to do is, right, our survey also find out these are the challenges facing most of the merchants that get started. Sales and traffic. Of course, no traffic, you definitely cannot convert to sales. Then what we do is, right, about 2 years ago, we start building the bridges. The idea is, if you are a new merchant onboarding, you want to be your own brand, okay, but it will take time for you to learn all the tricks. You can start pushing your products to the place, right, that have a lot of traffic. And what are those places? Marketplaces. Okay? Because marketplaces, right, spends tons of money, really tons of money to drive traffic, to acquire customers. And that's why, right, they're charging you a commission for every single transaction. So we started off with pushing product to Lenon. Okay, then 11th Street, Lazada, Rakuten. Of course, Rakuten, you can't utilize it now with our platform. And why this is important? We want to share with the merchant, it's important to be your own branded store. Because eventually, a site owned by your own domain name, your own brand, with a list of customers, that rank, right, very high for keywords relevant in Google one, you can sell for a lot more money when you want to sell off your business that time. Compared to just the account in marketplace. Okay? And don't mistaken for that, marketplace customers are never really your customer. You don't actually own those details. And what we can do nowadays is we enable you have the best of both worlds. While you are selling at your own stores, right, utilizing a platform like WebShaper, you can push product to the marketplaces. And you can even push different pricing at a discounted price, or you want to push more, you know, to absorb the commission, we empower you to do that. And this is what we are working on in the pipeline also. Launch on Shopee Gen 5 for the local one. And in the coming 3 months time, you'll see us launching Amazon, eBay, and Qtech. Mainly to enable you to actually sell overseas, to earn USD. Okay, this is what we aspire to do. Okay, and if you are running a physical shop also, we have this iPad post. You can search for WebShaper inside our iPad app. You can actually have a live demo on it. That is synchronized, right? Whatever sold on your store, it will take out the stock from your online store. And vice versa. This is a unique selling point of what we are offering here. Okay. Last but not least, we have classes. You can check out our site, webshaper.com/training. You don't want to know more, right, about how to build your own web store or how to utilize WebShaper, right, to manage your multi-channel setup. Okay? I think that's all I'm going to end today's sharing. Any question regarding marketplace, sir? Or web store? Don't be shy. Anything at all? Yeah? Yeah.
So, what is
Shopify? Shopify is like what we are doing here, like WebShaper. It's a platform, right? We call it a software as a service, subscription one. You subscribe to the platform, it's a hosted service. You don't need to buy any other hosting or whatever. You get an account, you log in, you start uploading your product. Okay, then you start uploading, right? You start setting up, you have your own web store to run your own branded store. This is a free trial.
Okay.
Yeah. Something like what we are doing in WebShaper. But basically, it's a platform to enable you to build your own web store. So in the market now, if you want to build your own online store, right, there are, in general, two ways to go about it. subscribe to a web store platform, software as a service type. Okay, you pay monthly or yearly, then they give you a support, they give you maintenance, they give you enhancement. You have new features roll out, right, they push with you. Another type is you go for open source one. You need to buy hosting, right? Maybe you ask some company to help you to deploy WordPress using WooCommerce, OpenCart, PrestaShop, Magento. These are the four types of very popular open source, right? I think that currently dominate the world market now, not just for Malaysia. Did I answer your question? Anything else? If not, I think I'll end up here. Thanks again. You can catch us and my colleague Joyce, if you want to find out more about Web Shaper also, you can talk to her. Right, she will give you a piece of this brochure for you to understand more. Thank you.